dazzle us with their handmade Christmas goodies are Mum and Pom Pom Champion Sammy, Super.
She was the first person to ever teach me to make a pom pom when I was about 7. And it was just with a piece of cardboard out of a cereal box, and wrapping the wool around it.
These days, Sammy makes all sorts of cute pom-pom animals using that wonderful invention, the pom-pom maker, which you can get online or in shops.
I just wrap the wool around it, making sure it's even the whole way and nice and tight.
Once you've wrapped wool around each side, snip along the centre. Next, the important step. Tightly wrap wool around the middle. If it's not securely tied, it could spell pom-pom collapse.
As you can see, it's a really very fluffy pom-pom.
Add ears, eyes, a needle-felted nose and mouth, and it's looking less pom-pom, more bear. Now for a quick trim.
Almost like giving an animal a haircut, which I used to do a lot as a veterinary nurse. I've had practice. That is my finished Christmas bear. Sometimes I give them a little bit of makeup as well, but I quite like her, just plain.
As if this cute little bear isn't impressive enough, Sammy's got something very special up her sleeve for my competition.
A bit of a rough design, but it's huge to make really big, giant pom-poms.
Wow, that's the biggest I've ever seen. I can't wait to see what sort of pom-pom creation that will make. At Christmas HQ, with the wool wound on the giant pom-pom maker, it's crunch time.
This is the nearest thing I'm ever going to get to a David Attenborough moment. I feel like I'm at the birth of a sort of white leopard. A rare and beautiful creature, this giant pom-pom.
Because it's homemade, it's...
Like all great things, it has its... Yeah. Peculiarities.
This is definitely the most stressful bit.
Oh, God. What's interesting here is that Sam's using twine, not wool, for this, because pom-pom this big, you couldn't trust the wool not to break.
Just that. It does look very messy right now.
No, but babies look pretty messy when they first come out. Then they clean up good.
God for that.
It's out, it's born, I feel like a true pom-pom.
You're brilliant, thank you.
It's a one born every minute handmade Christmas special.
I feel the great fondness now that she is growing up so quickly.
What is making eyes at me over at Sammy's desk? That giant fluffy pom-pom baby has transformed into an elegant deer.
Sammy, having presided at the birth of this young lady, gentleman, what do we think?
Lady.
Lady, yes. I think eyelashes, she's got eyelashes. Yeah. I feel a great fondness now that she is growing up so quickly. Is there anything I can do to contribute?
Well, I've only got one more bit left to do.
Yes.
It's just to put some spots onto the front of the face.
Oh, so some needle felting.
We're using a needle felting tool and fluffy yarn to add details to the deer's face.
You just got to not be too rough, otherwise it will sink into the pom-pom.
It will go too much.
Yeah.
So it's just a bit of a plique.
Yeah. Right. Otherwise it'll end up with a huge hole in its nose.
Happy?
There we go. Perfect, thank you.
Thank you so much.
And then I just literally just keep doing more.
She's very useful.
The countdown to the end of their 4 hours is on, so I'm leaving my... Sammy's festive pom-pom deer is next, and if this doesn't say ho-ho-ho, then quite frankly, I'm not sure what does.
Wow, and look at this.
Yeah,
just
this one...
Amazing, isn't
fascinating
it?
Fascinating to be this one.
Yeah. Just the fact that it's a... pom-pom is just baffling my mind right now.
Yeah.
You should have seen her being born, Hayley.
And again, to be able to sculpt something like this,
yeah,
is just amazing.
Even the finishing touches on the top and the attention to the details,
yeah,
it's all there, isn't it?
Yeah, it's
some friendly taxidermy as well. It really does sing Christmas as well. It's a real Christmassy piece, this one.
Yeah, it's really uplifting, isn't it?
Finally.
Winner. Everyone put that all into.
I'm going to hand over to you two.
It's so hard.
It's been such a hard competition to judge. I think the standard and the thoughtfulness that have gone into each of these Christmas gifts is just above and beyond what we were expecting to find today. It's incredible. So well done, all of you. After a bit of a discussion, we've come up with a clear winner.
And the winner of this year's Christmas handmade gift competition is the giant pom-pom deer.
Thank you. Well done. That was incredible. Thank you. Congratulations. Thank you very much.
Thanks so much.
Move over, Bambi. Sammy has taken this year's trophy with her sensational pom-pom deer.
The experience has been amazing. If you think that your work's unique and you've just got that creative mindset, then go for it.
This amazing array of Christmas gifts is incredible.